dann nur um.
Now we will have the intercession of the saints, and we pray for Elise and Elias, and you will respond, pray for us. Holy Mother of God, please help me, pray for us. Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Eugene,
pray for us.
Saint Gaspar, all holy men and women. Now I will now do the prayer of exorcism and anointing of the oil of catechumens before the baptism. This oil is very important, that the sin, the original sin of this young people, young children, will be removed. In all of us have original sin, and because of baptism, that original sin that we inherited from Adam and Eve will be removed. So by baptism, those who are baptized were removed that original sin. Okay. So now I will do it for the babies. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, spirit of evil, to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness and bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set them free from original sin. Make them a temple of your glory, and send the Holy Spirit to dwell with them. There are three things, huh? Removal of original sin and sending of the Holy Spirit to them. We anoint you with the oil of salvation. In the name of Christ our Savior, may He strengthen you with His power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, we now ask God to give His child new life in abundance through water and the Holy Spirit. Now I will bless the water that we will use for baptism. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a symbol of the grace you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathe on the waters, making them the wellspring of holiness. The waters of great flood, you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Your Son willed that the water and blood showed forth from the side as He hung upon the cross. After this resurrection, He told His disciples, "Go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit." Father, look now with love upon your church and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of the Holy Spirit, give to the water of this font the grace of your Son. You created man in your own likeness. Cleanse him from sin and the new birth of innocence by water and spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism, Christ also with him in the newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The water is ready for baptism, but before we do that, we will renew our profession of faith. I would like you to answer clearly. Dear parents and godparents, you have come here to present these children for baptism by water and the Holy Spirit. They are to receive the gift of new life from God, who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring them up in the practice of the faith. See that the divine life which God gives them is kept safe and from the poison of sin, to grow always stronger in their heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism. Now, I'm gonna ask you to renew your vows during your baptism. Reject sin, profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church. This is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. Please answer clearly. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? I do or not? Please repeat. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
Amen.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
Amen.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin, the prince of darkness?
Amen.
Very good. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
Amen.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right side of the Father?
I
do. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We are proud to profess it in the name of Jesus the Lord. I once asked you, is it your will that Elise and Elias should be baptized in the faith of the church which we have professed today? Okay, please stand. First Elias, and then the godparents of Elias. Please come here. Elias first, Elias. Okay. So, father, and then the godparents at the back. And then someone can just wipe the head. Now, I baptize you, Elias, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Very good. So you may go back. Thank you very much. Next, Elise and the godparents of Elise. Godparents at the back.
Elise. I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Again.
Now, let us greet Elise and Elias as a member of the Christian community. Yay. Very good. Thank you. God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ had freed you from sin, given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and welcomed you into His holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, as Christ anointed priests, prophets, and kings. So may you live always as a member of His body, sharing everlasting life. I will now anoint you with the oil of chrism. This chrism is being used only 3 times in the life of a person: on baptism, on confirmation, and on ordination for us. So the baby after baptism will be consecrated to the Lord by the Holy Chrism, anointing with the oil of chrism. And then on grade 6 or grade 7, she or he will be confirmed. He or she will be anointed by the chrism again. And the third one, for those who have called for vocation to become priest or bishop, the priest is anointed. I was anointed with the oil of chrism in my hand, and for the bishop, anointed with the oil of chrism in their head. So this holy oil is very precious. This is only been blessed only once a year, only on Holy Thursday at the cathedral with the bishop and with all the priests. Therefore, now I anoint you with the oil of chrism at the crown of the head. Okay, now they are already on their white garment, Elise and Elias. You have become a new creation, and you have clothed yourself in Christ. See in these white garments the outward sign of your Christian dignity, with your family and friends to help you by word and example. Bring that dignity and stain into the everlasting life. The meaning of white cloth is purity. And that's their dignity. These children, Elise and Elias, don't have any more sin. No more original sin or any stain of sin at the moment. I am asking you to preserve that state of your dignity. It is also an invitation for us to preserve our own baptismal dignity by preserving, avoiding sin. Okay? So, you have cloth or something, or headdress, no more. That's okay. Now, I would like to ask the godparents to light the candles. Come here. For one side on the other side and one on the other side. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to keep burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. They are to walk always as a child of God.
then you may go back to your sins.
Let us now pray the Lord's Prayer because these children are already members of the Christian community. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us entrust these children to the care of Mary, our Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am encouraging you by teaching these kids to become faithful disciples of the Lord by participating in the Eucharist week and also praying together as a family. So, I would like to congratulate all of you, the parents, and the children for this wonderful sacrament of baptism. So, we can have now the... I will now give you the certificate for Elise.
Yay!
Also for Elias.
Yay!
So we can have now the people.
Yeah.
You can now distinguish the light.
Happy birthday.
Okay, now come over here. Okay, very good. Okay. Okay, mother.
Smile.
Thank you. Okay, next you can have your.
Ranino, Adene.
Thank you, Father.
Hello.
Say hi to Father.
Thank you.
Thank you.